Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm introducing a new series to my channel, which is gonna be a matchup guide for Gangplank versus any kind of champion that is like currently meta or generally played. The concept is pretty simple. I'm just gonna talk about how you should be playing against a certain champion as Gangplank in the laning phase, how to use your abilities, what runes and items you should go. So the matchup we're gonna talk about today is gonna be the Gangplank versus Akali matchup. I'm gonna start off by introducing the difficulty level to this matchup, which is gonna be between easy and normal. The reason why I put this matchup between easy and normal is because Akali is just your typical assassin that obviously when he gets really fed, it's gonna be very difficult to deal with. But obviously this comes with the price that she is kind of easy to deal with in the laning phase as long as you know what you're doing. So in this case with Gangplank, there are not tools and tricks that you can use in the laning phase to keep her under control and make sure that she doesn't go crazy throughout the game. So we're gonna start off by introducing the runes. So in the rune page you wanna be going against Akali is Grasp and Domination. You wanna go Grasp, Demolish, Second Wind and Overgrowth, and in the second page you wanna go Taste of Blood and Ravenous Hunter. This rune page will pretty much give you the necessary amount of sustain that you need to be able to stay in the lane and be able to poke and trade with the Akali. Now when it comes to early laning phase, it's gonna be pretty simple. You wanna use these runes together with a mana crystal and 3 pots to sustain and poke like I said before. Ideally, you wanna try to heal after Akali hits you with a Q in the early level so you can get hit by the ability and then heal back the damage. Also, a good thing to note is that if you have prior in the lane, which means that you're pushing towards her, it will force her to use Q to farm minions more than often, which will waste her energy and not allow her to trade back effectively. This is where you want to be using your barrels and just constantly pushing the lane, auto-attacking, to keep your grasp active and poker slash force her under the tower that way. It will also force her to use W defensively if an ability like her shroud does go on cooldown, creates a big gap in her kit and opens up a lot of options for Gangplank. Other ways to deal with Akali W is to use your barrels to zone her or pressure her. Obviously it becomes easier at level 7 and 13. Barrels cover quite a big part of her shroud, which puts a decent amount of pressure on her because she either is forced to leave her shroud and go defensively, or she can stay in the shroud at the risk that you can hit her with the barrels, so she will get punished for it. Other very simple tricks to deal with Akali shroud is simply by hovering your mouse over the shroud wherever you think she's gonna pop out and just start spamming your Q. Since your Q is a point and click, the moment you have vision of her, so the moment she attacks or does anything in her shroud, you will hit her with the Gangplank Q. Just make sure that there are no minions around, so you don't accidentally waste your Q on the minion. Other tricks to easily get off an auto-attack against Akali is to simply use attack move. You can use whatever binding you want for that, but if there are no minions around and you just stand in the shroud, you spam your attack move, and the moment you have vision of her, your character will attack her, if she is close enough. Doing this in combination with the previous barrel tricks and the standard stuff that you should know on GP, like sitting on your barrels, should make her shroud really easy to deal with. Now Akali does have a big level 6 spike. She can easily play with you and kill you with ignite and aura spells if you're not careful enough. So this is where the spell vamp and all the healing from your runes comes in very handy. I will explain why. The resolve tree gives you healing and HP with Grasp, Second Wind and Overgrowth, and your Domination rune page also gives you healing with the Taste of Blood and Ravenous Hunter. Now why is this useful? It's because the healing essentially doesn't allow her to easily poke it down to a percent of HP where she can kill you with one combo. And even if she does try to all in you, you will most likely survive because you heal back so much while fighting if you do play it correctly. This means using your passive resets, sitting in your R, using your barrels and using Grasp. Just so you know that your passive does heal from spell vamp that the Ravenous Hunter gives you. Once you get out of laning phase, things will look a lot better for Gangplank, since Gangplank does tend to scale better than Akali, and it becomes a lot easier for you to cat around her and use the bells to deal with her at moments like when you have your level 13, items like Stormraiser or Yomus, so you can cat around easier, etc. Now let's talk about how you should be building against an Akali as Gangplank. The items that you want to be going for in the laning phase to help you will be Sheen and Hexdrinker. Ninja Tabis can also be a decent item against Akali, since she does tend to use quite some auto attacks with her passive and items like Hextech Revolver and Gunblade, but I don't recommend rushing these boots since going for your Triforce is just way more effective. I do think that you should go Hexdrinker after Sheen though, if you end up going even against her in the laning phase, just because of how much skill pressure she has with her ulti and her overall burst damage with Ignite. After going Triforce, going for a Stormraiser or finishing Mao are not a bad idea. Later on you can go for items like Phantom Dancer to make it even more easier to deal with her in the side lane. So these are quite the general tips that you want to keep in mind whenever you're going against an Akali. Please let me know if I missed out on anything, and like usual, don't be afraid to ask me anything in the comments. I would really appreciate as well if you guys would recommend me matchups you want to see, or anything else you want to see of Gangplank. I'm thinking about doing like just a general like laning phase guide for Gangplank. I will also probably make a video once the crit changes go live and have a decent idea about how good it is, and also when the next season will start. I do stream on Twitch from time to time, so feel free to pass by. I just like to chill out with my viewers and talk about a lot of random stuff while showing off some cool Gangplank gameplay. Yeah, thanks for watching then, and I'll see you next time.